Coming up, the man who wants to lead Arkansas gets support from the man who leads America.
I am delighted that you have honored us by returning to Northwest Arkansas on the eve of another important election.
Meanwhile, his opponent spent Election Day Eve looking 24 hours ahead.
And what we all have to realize is that no race is over until you reach the finish line.
And it was a similar scene across the nation.
I'm Sally Kidd in Washington. The final push is on to get voters to the polls tomorrow. You'll hear from party strategists and pollsters next.
4029 News is next.
Live, local, late breaking. This is 4029 News.
You've probably been reading about the fact that some of the prognosticators have already decided the outcome of the election. That's not the first time that's ever happened.
As time ticks down, the president makes a last-minute push for the GOP candidate. Good evening. Welcome, everyone. I'm Donna Bragg.
I'm Craig Cannon. Thanks for joining us. Republicans across Arkansas relied on a little presidential pull to push them into office. It came in a presidential visit. Candidates hope voters will remember when they head to the polls tomorrow. Mike McCormick has more on the big story tonight. And, Mike, the president was in Northwest Arkansas for about an hour.
Yeah, Craig, and oddly enough, the president was actually here at the Tyson Hangar just before the election back in 2000, but then he was asking voters to choose him. This time, he wanted voters to choose Asa for governor.